Good morning, everyone, and a really warm welcome as we come to celebrate the fifth Sunday in Lent. And so may the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together the collect for today. Holy God and Lord of life, in Jesus Christ, you redefine our living and our dying. Grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to John, chapter 12, reading from verse 1. Glory to Christ our Saviour. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume, made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ.
Just recently, I've been reading and pondering some work by a man by the name of John Cacioppo, and I hope I pronounced that correctly. His work is on human social connection. And so it was in the light of this that I came to the gospel reading for this week. And in this gospel reading, we notice three interactions. We notice the touching account of Jesus as he comes to the family, and his relationship with that family is particularly evident. And then we see the very moving and most intimate account of Mary wiping Jesus' feet with oil, wiping his feet with her hair. In contrast to that, we have Judas, who stands aside, who stands alone, giving himself not to community, but to himself. And so that's what caught my attention as I read the gospel for today. When we go to Genesis, we read at the beginning of creation that God ensured that Adam and Eve had food, they had water, they had shelter, they had a beautiful place in which to live. But he noticed that there was one thing Adam still needed. And God said, "It is not good that man should be alone." So he recognized that humans had a need for community. And it was ordained then that we should be in relationship with another, with others, that we should live in community. In the Western world, we find it quite difficult to understand community, to ascribe to community. We venerate the idea of the tough individual who goes it alone, the one who single-handedly builds his or her own life. And that idea has become so pervasive today in our society that we live in private worlds, we defend our private rights, and we've even gone so far as to make faith a private matter. In days gone by, we were more accustomed to living in extended families. We no longer do that, particularly in Western culture. And in fact, even the nuclear family is beginning to become rarer and rarer. And in fact, in parts of Northern Europe and the United States, the number of people living on their own has risen remarkably in the last few decades. Families split up as they move from town to town, country to country, and that sense of cohesion has been lost. And all of these demographic shifts have led to increasing loneliness. So that loneliness has become a condition of the modern age. When we feel lonely, we feel pain. We feel an emotional pain, and sometimes we even feel a physical pain. And the author of the work that I mentioned at the beginning says that loneliness is the same as the feeling of hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst warn us that we need to take action. Loneliness is a pain that has a similar message to us. Something is wrong, and we need to do something about it. Loneliness is not a sign of weakness, as we often want to interpret it. I can live by myself. Loneliness is an indication that we need to reach out and reestablish connection. For we were not made to live alone. We know that. God knows that. Now, from a neurobiological perspective, we are made for social connection. Right here in our heads, we are designed for that purpose. And why would that be so? Well, we all know, particularly if we are women, that it takes a long, long, long time to raise children. They are vulnerable when they are born. They need particular and constant nurturing. And we are certainly, in the animal kingdom, have the longest period of raising our young. And from the beginning of time then, human beings could not raise their young on their own. They did not have the capacity to set aside resources. They did not have the capacity to fend off wild animals or any other threats, and at the same time, nurture a child who was in need of constant attention. If they did not have a community to support, to encourage, the child would not survive, and neither would the community. And so we need to service and live in service to one another so that our communities survive. That is the fabric of the human being. And yet today we think we do not need each other. Somehow, if we do, we are weak. And the same applies to us as spiritual beings. We are born into a spiritual life. We need to be nurtured by others. We need to nurture others. We need to have those around us who will show empathy and care and kindness. We need to have those who will pick us up when we fall down and remind us that we are the beloved of God. And we too need to be able to do the same to others in our community. Jesus touched people. He ate in their homes. He walked with them along dusty roads. He let people wash his feet with their hair. Jesus gave us an example of what it means to live in community, to cry with people, to laugh with people, to celebrate with people, to mourn with people. We are his body, and we should be longing to do the same. It is hard to thrive as a Christian without spiritual community. And COVID has been a very tough time for us. We've been forced into isolation, and almost a type of spiritual isolation, a social loneliness. And if you're feeling spiritually lonely, then it's time for us to rediscover each other, to rediscover the physical touch, the being together that Jesus gave us an example of. Judas chose to live for himself, and he ended up dying alone. Christ chose to give himself utterly to community, and finally for community. For which do you live? Yourself, or for the nurture and well-being of the body of Christ and the community it serves? It is not good for you to be alone. Amen.
Oh, just to belong.
To belong,
just to belong
in a family,
in a family,
God's family,
God's family,
just to be one,
just to be one
of his daughters and sons,
his daughters and sons.
It's what we really want,
it's what we really want,
to be known and loved.
In this place.
Father in his grace. On each face, we are precious in His sight when we sing our Father's praise. Just to belong
in a family,
God's family.
Just to be one
of his daughters and sons.
That's what we really want.
To be known and loved. No one alone in this place. Bound here together precious in His sight when we sing our Father's praise in God's family.
Wash me thoroughly for my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Hear the commandments which God has given to his people and take them to heart. I am the Lord your God. You shall have no other gods but me. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not make an idol of anything and worship it. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not make wrong use of the name of the Lord your God. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Remember the Lord's day and keep it holy. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Honor your father and mother. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not commit murder. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not commit adultery. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not steal. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not give false evidence. Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not covet the possessions of others. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Let us confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone, for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us. Pardon our sins and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
For anyone who's prayed 1,000 prayers and still can't find the answer anywhere, fighting off the lie that no one cares. For anyone who's out there losing hope, feeling you're forsaken and alone, clinging to the last strands of your rope, may God give you eyes to see still greater courage to rise and believe He's able. May God be your peace in the fire you're walking through. This is my prayer now. This is my prayer for you.
Gracious God, we offer you our thanks, praise, and love through Jesus Christ our Lord, who gave himself for us. Thank you for your holy church, which you sustain with your powerful, life-giving word. Your Son accepted the service of Mary. Bless your people everywhere who serve you in all kinds of ways. For those who serve in the church, especially our Bishop Nkosinathi, together with Thabo, our Metropolitan, and all clergy, church workers, and lay people. For those who volunteer their services in the community, for those who offer friendship, for those who befriend the disadvantaged, bless the service of all your people and assure them that you are well pleased with their work. Lord, in your mercy. Speak to the hearts of those who plan negatively against others. Show them that honesty is better than falsehood, and that peace is better than violence. Give to our political leaders a deep commitment to goodness and mutual well-being. Keep us all from the greed and false compassion of Judas. Lord, in your mercy. Your Son drew close to Lazarus and raised him from the dead. Be near to all people who are close to death, and grant them faith in you. Strengthen all who are preparing for the loss of loved ones, that they may make the most of their time with loved ones. And help all who work among the dying, doctors, nursing staff, chaplains, and volunteers. Lord, in your mercy. We pray that the earth may be freed from our neglect and abuse, cleansed from poison, and restored for God's glory, for all God's creatures. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, as a potter fashions a vessel from humble clay, you form us into a new creation. Shape us day by day through the spiritual season of Lent and Christ's companionship, until all our acts are loving and just. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly God, Mary honored the Lord with her gift of perfume. May we honor you in our lives by honoring all who are in need, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
We come as your people. We come. come as your own, united with each other, love finds a home.
We come to share our story, we come to break the bread.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right and our greatest joy to give you thanks and praise, O Lord our God, Creator and Ruler of the universe. You made a way through the sea, a path through the waters. Even now you are doing a new thing, making rivers flow in the desert, forming a people for yourself, that we might declare your praise. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with choirs of angels and prophets, apostles and martyrs, and all the faithful of every time and place who forever sing to the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are holy, O God of majesty, and blessed is Jesus, your Son, our Lord. You anointed Jesus with the gift of your Holy Spirit, a healing balm, a fragrant offering of love for the world. He is our Passover, our only hope for salvation. Remembering your gracious acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and this wine, and joyfully celebrate his dying and rising. As we await the day of his coming, with thanksgiving, we offer our very selves to you to be a living and holy sacrifice dedicated to your service. And on the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, he took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious God, pour out your Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and the blood of Christ. By your Spirit, unite us with Christ and with your Church in all the world. Teach us to know the surpassing grace of Jesus Christ our Lord, sharing in his suffering and rejoicing in the power of his resurrection, pressing on towards the goal to which you have called us. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Bread which we break, is it not a sharing of the body of Christ?
We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
So draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious.
God's mercy endures forever.
And so, as we have had Jesus offer himself to us in this meal, and as we seek to go out and connect with others in community, let us offer ourselves to God in those faithful words that we have been praying. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in your knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Just to be one.
Just to be one.
Of his daughters and sons.
Daughters and sons.
It's what we really want.
It's what we really want.
To be known and loved.
To be known and loved.
No one alone in this place. On each face,
on each face,
we are precious in His sight when we sing our Father's praise.